La question centrale dans cette
the crucial question at the heart of this session is to see how recycling of non-renewable raw material is sufficient to delay the consumption or depletion of non-renewable raw materials. When we consider the dynamic cycle, we see that the impact of recycling depends on one major factor, which is that of the annual growth of said raw material. If we grow at 2% per year, recycling has a smaller impact than if we grow at 4% or 5%. And a second important parameter, which is the time of stay of the material in the economy. How much time am I going to use the raw material before I turn it into a waste? And that's linked to another phenomenon, which is addition to stocks. If we take a look at this simple diagram on circular economy, we see that in this virtual city that we represented here on the surface of the Earth's crust, the raw material that we consume, which is the blue-green arrow in which we've written total, we see that it's two flows, the one at the bottom, which is the net addition to stocks, i.e. the quantity of material that adds to our raw material legacy, the fact that we have one additional stereo, one additional phone, etc. And the second flow is that of the material that we discard. And the total quantity that we consume is equal to the quantity added to our inventories plus the quantity that we've discarded. Circular economy consists in reintroducing a significant part of material contained in the waste in the production cycle for raw material, and recycling is going to be the efficacy. So what we'll see here are several indicators, the waste production ratio,
the
total addition to stocks as compared to total contribution, and the sum is total to 1 because the flow is equal to total consumption. And in fact, we can connect all this to the efficacy of weight, i.e. how much time, the efficacy of weight of recycling, how much time do I save with recycling as compared to the total concentrated quantity of raw materials. This can be shown in a diagram which is going to include three graphs connected to three assumptions regarding the efficacy of recycling, 30%, 60%, 90% if we discard a certain amount of raw material, 30 tons, 60 tons, or 90 tons are reintroduced in the loop. And this is how we can establish the growth rate, which we are going to say is going to be very low, 0.5% per year, to fit within the criteria of sustainable economy. And we vary the two other rates, i.e. the waste production rate, which is equal to 1 minus addition to stocks. When the first one is equal to 100%, the other one is equal to 1%. And this allows us representing the number of years we save with regards to resource depletion as compared to the scenario if we were to recycle absolutely nothing. If we were to recycle nothing, we would have an exponential graph. If we do recycle, the graph is going to be shifted over time. By how many years? Well, this is what is shown on the x-axis. If we want a sustainable economy, we need to have more than a century of shift to give time to the economy to adapt and to allow future generations to manage the evolutions in society. So we can look at what kind of graphs, on which graph we can exceed 100 or 150 years. And if we were to recycle a raw material at 60% to go beyond 100 years, we need and produce at least 70% waste. So when we consume 100 tons of steel, we need to dump 70 tons in waste that is going to be recycled. So we don't want to accumulate more. If we accumulate 100% of what we consume, we don't send anything as waste. We don't discard anything as waste. So everything we consume comes from the earth. If we produce lots of waste, almost as much as what we consume, it means that we do not accrue the quantity of material we extract from the earth. What we dump is what we consume, and if we have good recycling, we can gain time. So we can gain more than 100 years thanks to recycling, provided we produce waste equivalent to 80% of what we consume over the same period, i.e. if we do not accumulate more than 20% of what we consume over the same period. So sustainable economy avoids accumulating additional raw material and only consumes according to what it discards, if then there is massive recycling of waste. As an indication, and I think this example is a perfect illustration, new cars registered in the 90s or 2000, 20% are additional cars, so we are adding to stocks, we're adding 20% of consumption. And this is what this accumulation effect represents. And this is where we reach the limit of reliability. If the growth in cars registered was of 0.5%, and if we were to recycle steel in the cars, which is the case.